You know, he's got all he needs, but he's still headed for a heart attack. I'm frustrated. Here's the patient, here's the case. He just stood me up again. He's a 65-year-old wealthy business owner. His goals were to keep my blood sugar low, lower my blood pressure, and eat better. He's had heart procedures, he's had stents, he's had catheterizations. And his doc is seeing him and saying, we've got this covered now. We're giving him Repatha, the PCSK9s. They've got his LDL down into the mid-20s. But here's his labs. OGTT, fasting glucose, 111. Actually, he's had one fasting glucose that was over 200. His 1 hour OGTT peak glucose was 206. Again, optimum is 120 for peak glucose. Fasting glucose optimum is 80 or 90, 90 or less. Back to the OGTT, his 2 hour was 108. Optimum is 100 or less. And here's the other numbers. Insulin, you know already, he's got full-blown diabetes. He's not got just prediabetes. Full-blown diabetes, he's got a blood sugar over 200. Anytime you have that, it's diabetes. And some doctors will quibble with me over 200. Well, at the 1 hour, at the peak, no, that's not really technically it. Bottom line is, there's no difference between prediabetes, insulin resistance, metabolic syndrome, and full-blown diabetes, except a matter of degree. They all are reflecting the resistance of your insulin receptors in the cells, in your muscle cells and your liver cells, to insulin. They don't respond to insulin anymore, so your blood sugar stays up. If you're still able to make insulin, your insulin values go up. And yes, his insulin values were up too high as well. In fact, fasting or basal insulin was 8.2. Optimum is 5 or less. His 1 hour insulin was 109.5. Again, optimum is 50 or less. His 2 hour insulin was 68.9. Optimum is 20 or less. So his blood sugar's out of control. He's still making insulin. He's still making a lot of insulin. It's just that he's not responding to it. His receptors are resistant. And you know, especially in this time of the COVID epidemic, what about his vitamin D3? It's 21. Optimum is 60 to 80. So his arteries look like this. He's piling up plaque. He's already had plaque. And again, they think because they've decreased the LDL content in his blood, that he's not going to continue to build plaque, despite the fact that he's spending hours every day at blood sugar levels way over 200 and at insulin levels way over 100 and with very low vitamin D3 levels. I hope he doesn't get COVID infection. Now, who's to blame for this? Many of you watching would blame his doc. And yes, I do blame his doc, but how about the patient? I think, you know, a lot of people, a lot of doctors especially, would blame the patient, because guess what? He's got access to me. He's got access to some of the best information in the world to recognize and cure this problem, and he doesn't have time for it. He's ignoring it. You want to blame insurance companies? The doctors do, sometimes the patients do, and sure enough, you know what? If the insurance companies didn't pay doctors just to do prescriptions or procedures, maybe some of this wouldn't happen. Maybe docs would step into the role that they need to be in terms of coaching patients and teaching patients. You know what? Whenever we get into this blame game, you can always blame the government. And you know, once you go there, you can blame the Democrats, you can blame the Republicans. Here's the thing, it's your health, it's your body. You know, we all know that diabetes will cause heart attacks, strokes, and a bunch of other really bad stuff. But what very few of us know, including this patient, including his doc, is that over half of us have prediabetes. We have problems metabolizing glucose. Not just old people, unless you consider 30 years old, but one out of two, half the people in the state of California, already been demonstrated by a UCLA study over 2 years ago. Half the people over age 30 have prediabetes or full-blown diabetes. Here's the other thing, even if people began to know that, and it's not like it's not available, this was out in the LA Times. So I guess maybe some people would say, I'm glad I'm not in California. The Californians, they have a few more ethnicities, which tends to raise some of the probabilities here, but that's not the issue either. We all have this problem. Here's the other thing that people don't know. Number one, they don't know how prevalent this problem is. Number two, they don't know how to test for it. If they knew how to test for it, they knew it, something like a Kraft insulin survey or even an OGTT, maybe a lot more people would begin to recognize what's going on. So please, test. Stop guessing. Stop driving through life with no dashboard. Get a dashboard and start figuring out what's going on with your health. Thank you for your interest.
We continue to get great feedback regarding the webinars, and here's why. You know, on the internet, when you hear a webinar, you expect for somebody to try to sell you something. We're not doing that. We're trying to tell you something. People are coming in with their labs from Quest, inflammation panel, OGTT, insulin survey response, and then they're finding out, do I have inflammation? Do I have insulin resistance? And where does that fit in terms of other folks? We're getting ready to start one for CIMT as well. So again, people are really excited about finding out their own status. Looking forward to seeing you there. Thanks.